And we continue our coverage of the Pope's apostolic visit to Myanmar, also known as Burma. Today, Pope Francis says the Buddhist nation's future depends on respecting the rights of every ethnic group. And the Holy Father met today with Myanmar's civilian leader, Aung San Suu Kyi. Pope Francis did not use the contested word Rohingya in his speech. More than 600,000 members of that Muslim minority group have fled to Bangladesh. That's where the Pope will visit later this week. The Pope insists everyone who calls Myanmar home deserves to have their basic human rights and dignity guaranteed. Edward Penton from EWTN's National Catholic Register is traveling with the Pope. He joins us now from Yangon. Ed, is this a peacemaking mission for the Holy Father?
Yes, it is, Lauren. Well, like all of his trips, really, certainly of late, they've all been to places where there have been sort of conflicts and tensions. And he sees his role very much as Pope as being a sort of peacemaker. And that's been seen today. He gave two speeches today, one privately, which was to interreligious leaders, in which he gave a sort of pathway to peace. He said that there shouldn't be colonization, so everything is the same in uniformity. He said there must be unity and diversity. And then he spoke at a very important message today to the civil authorities, in which he said that human dignity must be respected and that ethnicities and identity must be respected too. So it's very sort of comprehensive speeches here, really upholding, trying to push for peace.
Well, the Pope has come to Myanmar in part to draw attention to the plight of religious minorities, as you said, the Rohingyas, and it's an issue that is important to him. But can you give us a snapshot of what he has done for other persecuted minorities, including Christians, during his pontificate?
Yes, well, Lauren, the main thing, of course, is the visits. I mean, he's come here where Christians are a very small minority here. They're under quite a lot of pressure. There are problems with religious freedom here, but also the Rohingyas, as you say. And he's been to Egypt earlier this year, which was also really on behalf of the persecuted Christians there. But he also has called a lot for prayer for persecuted Christians in particular, but also for minorities everywhere. And his whole outreach to refugees is really a part of that.
Edward Penton, thank you so much for joining us, correspondent for EWTN's National Catholic Register.
Thanks, Laura.